What's going on, guys? So today's video is a follow-up video to a few videos I've made in the past, with the discussion really being focused around diesel versus gas pickup trucks, because things have kind of changed a little bit, but not too much, and kind of understanding the limitations of each, well, the limitation more so of a gas engine, I think is important, because this is probably the number one or number two most commonly asked question I get in the comment section or in emails from my viewers. So hang tight, I'll be right back. All right, so again, number one, number two most commonly asked question is related to whether somebody should get a new truck with a gas engine or a diesel engine, specifically 3/4 ton or 1 ton. You're seeing a huge emphasis with truck manufacturers to put out better gas engines. Not necessarily larger displacement, right? You see Ford with the 7.3 liter V8 gas engine, but you're not seeing that same shift from everybody. You know, most of the manufacturers are putting out gas engines that are pretty much the same displacement, maybe slightly different than their current generation or previous generation trucks, but you're getting a lot more horsepower and torque out of them. And with these 10-speed transmissions that you're starting to see, or 8-speed transmissions you're starting to see that come in these trucks, you know, the question really exists out there: should you opt for a gas versus diesel if gas engines are becoming more and more capable? And that's a hard question to answer, because it really comes down to what type of experience you're looking for, what type of range you're looking for, and what type of terrain you plan on traversing. If you're going to be going up hills a lot, or up mountain passes a lot, or down hills and down mountain passes, basically up and down grade often, then, you know, for most of your heavier RVs, and I would say 12,000 pounds or greater, you will feel much more comfortable with a diesel engine. It's just going to give you that torque that you're looking for to manage the weight going up the hill, and that exhaust brake you're looking for when you're coming down the hill. And regardless of which exhaust brake we're talking about, whether it is the Ford, the Ram, or the GM, you know, Ram arguably having the best, but they're all good, and they're all going to give you far more confidence than a gas engine brake, right? So you're going to basically have just a better overall towing experience if that's the type of towing you plan on doing, or if you foresee yourself doing that type of towing. Now, under 12,000 pounds, it's not gonna matter that much, mainly because any of these new gas-equipped trucks are gonna have the towing capacity, the payload capacity, and the build that you're looking for to be able to manage that type of weight through almost any conditions. And all that diesel is going to have an advantage for in that weight range really is how easy it does it. You know, it's the difference between where your RPMs are going to be, the amount of strain on your engine and transmission, all of that on those lighter weight trailers. Now, if you are looking from a cost perspective, you know, diesel is still running about $8,000 to $10,000 more than a gas equipped truck. So if you have a travel trailer or a small fifth wheel and you're in that 12,000 pound GVWR or less range, then a gas engine might be the better choice for you, simply because it's gonna cost you significantly less. You know, the fuel economy of both trucks is gonna be very similar whenever you're not towing. You will get a slight advantage with a diesel engine when you are towing, probably 2 to 3 miles per gallon better. You know, in terms of longevity of the engine, diesel engines typically last longer, but they also require a bit more maintenance. But at the end of the day, a gas engine might be perfect for your specific application. Shoot, a couple years ago, I was even considering adding a truck to the channel. It was a 2019 Ram 3500 single rear wheel with a 6.4 liter Hemi. And, you know, I really liked that truck. I really liked the experience I got. I liked the power. I liked everything about it. And if I was just going to be towing, you know, a 9,000 pound cargo trailer or my dump trailer, things like that, that truck would have performed very well. Where its limitations would have come into play is if we ever tried to pull like the fifth wheel, or we ever tried to pull something that weighs over that 12,000 pound. And really, when you start moving from 10 to 12,000 pounds is where you start seeing the most difference. Now, I'm not going to say it's going to be this huge, dramatic, groundbreaking difference, but it will gradually start ramping up quickly from that point, and you will start noticing the weight significantly more. So let's say you're looking at a trailer between 6 and 10,000 pounds. Again, you'll start to notice the difference in the towing capability of your truck when it comes to those sizes of trailers pretty quickly. And then as you go higher, you're going to notice it even more, especially when you're stopping or slowing down with that weight pushing on you from the back. Even with your trailer brakes dialed in perfectly, shoot, even with disc brakes, you're going to feel it. And, you know, we always like to have that conversation about, do you feel the weight while you're towing it? Weight is one of those things that's so important to understand, and how the dynamics of a trailer or whatever you're towing or whatever you have in the bed of your truck can impact the performance of your truck in terms of acceleration, in terms of handling, but most importantly, in terms of braking, how you're stopping that weight. Because what you don't want to do is you don't want to get a truck that requires a trailer with stronger brakes in order to be able to control it, right? You don't want to be in a situation where you're going down a hill, you're going down a mountain pass, you're on a 6% grade, and you have a trailer that would normally be too heavy for your truck, but you're pushing it, and now you have some type of a brake issue with your trailer, and your truck's just not able to control that weight. That's really where, like, your diesel exhaust brake comes in very, very handy. Having a diesel engine exhaust brake on your truck basically gives you that additional security blanket that you need, so you're not putting all the wear and tear on your traditional disc brakes. So at the end of the day, you know, to answer the question, 12,000 pounds and up, if you want the most comfortable towing experience, diesel. If you want the most grunt towing any trailer, diesel. If you're trying to save some money and you don't want to spend the extra money for diesel and you don't really care about having that excessive amount of towing capacity, gas. You know, under 12,000 pounds, gas. That's essentially the way I kind of view it. Because I think if you stick with those numbers, you'll generally be in a pretty good place, and you don't have to go through all the minutiae of every little aspect. Now, the one thing I do want you to keep in mind is if you are looking at a 3/4 ton truck, and you are looking at towing a fifth wheel, or shoot, even a 1 ton single rear wheel truck, and you're considering towing a fifth wheel with it, having a diesel engine will significantly reduce the payload capacity of your truck. And manufacturers started realizing this, so what they started to do was actually increase the gross vehicle weight rating of trucks that normally would have a 10,000 or an 11,500 or a 12,000 pound GVWR. Well, they started increasing it to like 13,000 pounds or 13,500 pounds for a single rear wheel truck, just so they could give you the payload rating you needed with a diesel engine. And quite frankly, finding some of those trucks are really difficult, and Ford even got in trouble because they were mislabeling their trucks by like 500 pounds worth of cargo capacity in some cases on some trucks. So understanding what having a diesel engine versus a gas engine does to your payload capacity is also really important. And it will help you understand why maybe an F-350 or a Ram 3500 or a 3500 HD from GM is going to be a better choice if you're getting a diesel engine, because you will have the higher GVWR, you will have less impact of the diesel on the overall cargo capacity. You can still get a truck with 3,200 to 3,600 up to 4,000 plus pounds worth of cargo capacity with a diesel in a 1 ton single rear wheel configuration, where once you spec a diesel into a 3/4 ton truck, a lot of times it's going to bring your payload capacity down to like 1,800 pounds or maybe up to about 2,500 pounds properly equipped. So just keep that in mind. Anyways, guys, I sure hope you enjoyed this video. If you haven't had a chance, please take a moment, subscribe to my channel, give me a thumbs up, and we'll talk to you again very soon.